So in this video, we are going to learn how we can validate a data that is coming from a REST API or from a file that could be a JSON or a text file. And using Pydantic, we are going to validate everything. So further in this video, we will learn how we can parse the data, how we can apply validation on the basis of our own logics. And then we will learn how we can put this data to a JSON or a serializable object. So welcome to my channel. I'm your host, Rahul. Let's get started. Now, to demonstrate this, I have a sample data set, and this is in this data.json. If we check this data.json, we have a list of dictionaries, and in this dictionary, I have simple information of a user, that is email, phone, address, and after this, we have items. Now, this item is basically the item that user has purchased from a store. Now, if you check this, we have item ID, name, price, and the quantity that user has bought. Now, if you further check the data, then we have discount as well in this item. Now, we need to handle this as well in the code. Now, let's go back to the main.py and define all the classes that we are going to use to validate this data. So, before starting, you need to install Pydantic in your system. For that, we have pip install Pydantic, and also we are going to use this email string. To install this email string, we have this particular command. So, once Pydantic is installed, we can start coding. Now here we can see that I have imported base model, email string, field, and validation error. Now we are going to use this base model to define any of our classes which are going to validate the dataset. And then we have email str, and this email string is something that we are going to use to validate the emails. Now if we move forward, then we have field. So this field helps us define the basic description, title, or any other constant that we can provide to any of these key that we have in our data. So we'll see everything later. Now from typing, we are using list and optional. Now before defining the classes, let's have a look on the data JSON again. So if we go back to our data JSON and let's reformat this. So for that, we'll simply select all, right click on this and click on this format selection. So if you see now, data is formatted properly. Now inside this main dictionary here, we have address, and this again is a type of dictionary. Further, if you see, we have items, and this item is of type list, and inside this list we have again dictionaries which store the item information. So now we have to define classes that will handle all these individual dictionaries by itself. So let's go back to our main and define the address that we have. If we check this, so here I have already written the code. I'll simply explain and will also do modification in the later stage. This is just a boilerplate that I'm going to use. Now, if you see this address here, here we have house number, zip code, and city. And if you check all these, all are in string format. We have all house number, zip code, and city as string. So let's go back to our main and check. So first we need to inherit the base model. And after that, we are going to define all the attributes of this address. So we have house number, zip code, and city. So we can see here that this zip code is optional, which means that we may or may not have the zip code in our data. So we are using this zip code as optional because there are chances that we may not have the zip code. So let's go to our JSON data and see if we have such case or not. So let's scroll down, and here at the end, I can see that we don't have the zip code in this address. So this is another case where we can add optional field to the fields that are not required. And there is another way to handle the zip code, that we can add a default value. Now to add a default value, now let's suppose we don't have the city. Then in order to add default value to the city, we can simply write here equal to, and then we can define something like Delhi, right? And save this. So this will assign Delhi to all the entries which don't have city. So this will handle the default case, but for now this is a required field, so I'll remove this from here. So this was about the address. Then we move to item, and if we check item from our data.json, then we have item ID, item name, item price, and quantity. Now we have item ID, which is an integer, then we have item name, which is string, then item price, quantity, and discount. All these are integers. Here in item quantity and discount, we can see that discount has a default value of 5 and quantity is also having a default value of 1. So in case we don't have the quantity, it will take a by default value of 1 and 5 for quantity and discount respectively. So let's check the JSON as well. So here in this scenario, we have the discount, but further if we see up that in this scenario, we were not having the discount, right? So this will handle the case. Now let's move to invoice. And in this invoice, we have the email, which is of type email string that we have imported. And after this, we are using the phone number. Now to this phone number, I have defined certain patterns that it should start from the code that we have, that is +91 for India. And after this, we have this digit specification, which says that we only can have 10 digits, not more than or less than it. So this is a regex that we are providing to this field. Now, if you check this help from VS Code, we can see that there are multiple options to it. Alias is there, then we have validation alias, then serialization, title, description, example, exclude. So all these are useful for different scenarios. Now, if we define description, it will give us the hint that we can add certain values or what is this field for. And same goes with title, we can give any value to this. So there are n number of things that we can do with this field. Now, but here we are simply using the pattern, which is of type regex. Now let's move on further. Then we have this address. Now this address is the class that we have defined here. Now then we have this items, and this items is of type list. And inside this we'll be having object of this particular list item, which is defined here, right? And at the end, we simply have the total price, which is of type float. So this is the very basic of Pydantic. Now let's simply run the code and see what is the output of this. Now, after this, I'm simply reading this file from data.json, assigning it to data.json list and iterating this data. Now, base model has a function named model validate, which is going to validate the dictionary that we are going to pass. So here we are simply iterating this data.json list, and then we are passing it to our model validate function, and we'll print it if everything goes fine. So let's run this and check. Now we'll simply open up the terminal and run main.py. So we'll increase this terminal size. Now here I'm using this clear in order to clear the terminal when I run this command next time. And here we have python3 main.py. So let's run it. Now we are getting this error because we don't have this zip code here. And in the JSON also, we just saw that zip code was missing from the last entry that we had, right? Now I verified this with the Pydantic documentation. And here in this documentation, we can find that along with this optional, we also have to define none, which means that it will assign none value to all the missing values of this particular key that we have. So let's go back to our code and do the same. So we'll simply write here equals none, right? And save, and let's rerun this, right? So this time it has successfully executed all the commands. And in this address here, for the last entry, we can see that zip code is set as none. Also, I'll show you one more thing, that for all the previous entries, we can see the zip code is of type string, whereas in the output, we can see the zip code is of type int. So this is happening because we have defined zip code as an optional integer field, and it is simply parsing all the values that it is getting to integer if it is of some other type. So here we can see that this zip code here is of type integer, and here we are simply getting none, right? Now this was the basic validation of Pydantic. Suppose I want to apply a few more validation, few more condition, that this quantity here that we are getting should be greater than 1, or this discount should be in range of 1 to 100. So to check all those things, we can apply some custom validations as well. So to achieve that, we'll have to define another function. So let's do that. Now let's close the terminal here. Let's define the validator for this. So we'll write here at, now here we are going to define the field validator. So we'll write here at field validator. And after this, we are going to define the function name with which we are going to verify this field. So we can write def verify and discount. And this will take the class comma value. And this value will be of discount, and we'll then define it here. Now here in this field validator, we need to define on which field we have to use this particular function. So we'll simply write here discount. So discount. right? And we'll save this. Again, this is giving some issue. So we'll click on this quick fix. We can see that it is not imported. So we'll simply click on this and this is now imported here. So we'll save. So this will work now. Now let's define the logic for this verify discount. So we'll simply write. So we'll write here if value is less than 0 or value is greater than 100, then we'll simply raise the error that the discount needs to be proper. So then we'll write raise discount must be from 0 to 100. We'll then save this and here simply we'll return value if everything is fine. So let's save this. Raise, and here we are going to raise the value error. So we'll write her value and we have this here. So now we have to pass the message which this value error will raise when user is providing some wrong values. So we'll write here simply discount must be from 0 to 100. Now let's make some modification in our data.json. I have already done that. So here in this we can see that discount is 200 and in this one I am simply giving it a negative value. So let's save our main file and rerun this. So now we can see we are getting two error for two different entries. The first one has executed successfully, but in the next one we can see discount must be from 0 to 100, value error, input value is minus 20, and in the next error we can see again input value is 200. So by this we can verify that our validator is working fine. Now there is another way to handle this range type of problems. So for that we can simply use the field type. Now let's apply a custom validation on this quantity using field that we have imported with this Pydantic, right? So for that we are going to replace this and instead write here field, and in this field we are going to define its title first. So we'll write here title and let's give it as item quantity, right? And after this let's define the description as well. So we'll write here description total item purchased. After this we want to define that this quantity should be greater than 0. So we'll simply write here GT and equals 0, right? So it will check all the values which are greater than 0. So let's save this and also let's modify this discount as well that we have changed for the previous condition. So yeah, let's save this and run it. So now we can see all these values have successfully passed, right? But now let's pass the quantity that we have here as negative 1 and for this let's define it as 0. Let's see whether we get error properly or not. So let's go back to our main and run this. So here in the output we can see the first object has passed properly but the second one is giving an error. So if we check the error here, we are getting input should be greater than 0 and the input value that is passed here is again 0. So it has given this error. And in this scenario when we have passed minus 1 as an input, again this is throwing the error. So in this way we can use field to validate our data. So now let's move on to the next functionality of Pydantic, that is serializing the data. So to serialize the data we simply have to use an inbuilt function of base model, that is model dump. So we'll write here model dump and that is going to give the serialized data of this. So let's save and run this function. So we have modified the data JSON. So let's revert the changes that we have done. Let's save this and rerun this. So here we can see that we are getting the serialized value of whatever value we have passed inside this invoice. And we are simply printing that out. Okay. And also let's do one thing. We along with printing all the values, we have option to include or exclude the data. So let's write here. So we can write exclude first. So we'll write exclude and let's exclude the address of the user. So we'll simply pass her address and let's save and run it. And now this time we can see that we don't have the address. Like here is the email, here is the phone, and then we have items and total price, but address is missing from this. This is because we have used exclude here. So now let's change this exclude to include. So we'll write here include equals and let's remove this and let's make this address as email. So we'll just get all the emails of the users. So now let's rerun this file. So here is the output. And now we can see that we are only getting the email of all the data that we have here, right? So in this way, we can either include or exclude the keys that we have. So now we have seen that we can easily serialize the data, whatever we have parsed through this invoice and model validate. Now let's try to create a JSON out of it. So for that, we'll simply use another function. So that is model dump. And this time we want the JSON. So let's save this and remove this value for now. And let's see the output. So let's save this and rerun it. So now we can see we are getting the JSON out of this. Also, we can define the indentation. So we can write here indent and we can let's pass here 4 and let's see what is the output in this scenario. And this time we can see the data is printed in indented form. So this is another helpful function of paste model and Pydantic. Now here also we can use this include, exclude. In this way we can print out the JSON of the data that we have just parsed, right? So in this way we can see that we have started from parsing the data from very basic validation that we have, that is using all these built-in functions. Then we have defined a validator, and inside this validator we have defined all our logics, and using that logic we are again parsing the data. And after that we saw how we can convert this to JSON or to a serializable object, right? So this was all about Pydantic. I'll attach the link of Pydantic documentation. Now you can also go to this Pydantic documentation that we have, and inside this we have n number of options and many more things that we can do with the data that we are parsing, or there are multiple ways we can validate, serialize the data. We can add alias and do multiple things, right? So I'll say have a look on this as well. So that was all from my side. If you have liked the content, don't forget to subscribe it. This motivates me to create more videos. Thanks for watching.